Hey everybody! Welcome to Chill and Shuffle. You see this sign behind me? Although it's probably backwards for you guys. But I am in my she shed, my favorite place on the planet. And on my she shed is the big word remember. And I put that word remember on there because a lot of times in the Bible, what God wants us to do when we're going through a hard time is to remember Him. Remember His faithfulness so that you can trust Him next time. So on here are all the things that I want to remember about God. And there's lots and lots of things that I'm thankful for. Lots and lots of things that the kids are thankful for and that Mr. Brian is thankful for. Anybody that comes into my sheet check gets to write something that they have seen God work in. So that when I'm feeling kind of yucky or when I go, God, I don't even trust that you're here. I don't understand that you have a plan. Then I can look at here, I can come in here and I can say, oh, you've been faithful before, you're gonna be faithful again. Usually in the Bible, what they would do was they would ask people to make an altar. Say, make an altar here and remember what I've done. And the story, we've been going through the Old Testament, remember? Which is the beginning of the Bible. And we've learned about Abraham and Sarah, and we've learned about Noah, and we've learned about Joseph. And now we're about to learn about Moses. Now the Jews, who are God's people, God's chosen people, the Jews, are about to need to remember that He's a good God. And we're going to see why they need to remember to trust Him. Here we go.
Joseph and his brothers were in Egypt. Everyone was all right, and they had enough food, which is great. But which of God's promises had come true? Had Abraham's family become a great nation? Nope. Abraham and Sarah had a son, and all the kids and their kids numbered about 70 people. That's a big family, but it's not a whole nation. Did they have their own land? Nope. They were living in Egypt, someone else's land. Had they blessed the whole world? Well, they didn't even know what the promised land meant. How did one family bless the whole world? On three big promises given to Abraham, at this point, a total of zero had come true. When Jacob's sons had kids, and their kids had kids, and their kids had kids, and a lot of kids, there were hundreds of kids, and then thousands of kids, and the Pharaoh, who was Joseph's friend, died, and there's a new Pharaoh, and then a new Pharaoh after that, and pretty soon Egypt was being ruled by a Pharaoh who didn't know anything about Joseph. He just knew that there were thousands and thousands of these people running around, these children of Israel. Remember how God changed Abraham's name to Abraham and Sarai's name to Sarah? Well, God had changed Jacob's name to Israel. So all of Jacob's children and his grandchildren and his great-grandchildren became the children of Israel. They were also called Israelites. Now, the new Pharaoh said, hey, there are too many Israelites around here. And he decided to do something about it. First, he made the Israelites slaves in Egypt. A slave is a person who was owned by another person. Being a slave meant the children of Israel had to do whatever Pharaoh said. They had to build stuff and farm stuff and clean stuff. Being slaves also meant they couldn't leave Egypt, ever, which is a big problem. If you remember God's second promise that his people would have their own land, how can they have their own land if they can't leave someone else's? But it got worse. The children of Israel kept having more kids, more and more kids, and eventually there were so many babies that Pharaoh decided to do something really, really bad. He wanted to get rid of the Israelites. Every Israelite baby boy, he said, should be thrown into the river. Then God gave one Israelite woman an idea. When her baby boy was young, she made a basket that floated like a boat and put her baby inside. And then she hid the basket in the tall grass on the edge of the river and waited to see what God would do. A group of Egyptian girls were washing in the river, and they saw the basket. And they opened it up, and what? There's a baby in there! One of the girls decided that she would take him home and raise him as her own son. Can you guess who that girl was? Who's that girl? It's Pharaoh's daughter. The daughter of the king of Egypt. Pharaoh's daughter brought home an Israelite baby to live in the palace just like an Egyptian. Right next to the Pharaoh. She gave the baby a name. Moses. And he was about to become part of a very big God's rescue plan.
Moses' mom, she had to remember that God is good. Then she had to listen to God and then do what he said. That's hard. That's hard sometimes. I bet she was scared. You bet she was scared? I wonder what she was thinking. I wonder what the Pharaoh's daughter was thinking when she saw a basket with a baby in it. I wonder what the Pharaoh thought when she brought home a baby. Did he know right away that it was an Israelite? That baby Moses was a Jew? All I know is that something bad happened, but God made something even better happen from it. And we're going to learn next week how God is going to take this yucky thing, how he's going to save Moses, and by saving Moses, he's going to save all of his people. God has a really big rescue plan. He wants to save us. He loves us. He wants us to remember all of these stories. He wants us to remember all the times he was faithful. But there's going to come a day that are kind of hard. Do you have hard days? Miss Sarah has hard days. And when I have hard days, it's so nice to remember how good God is. You guys ready to pray? Dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for helping us to remember all the times that you were good. God, we love you. Help us to sit down today and think about all the times that you were faithful. Thank you for saving Moses. We love you, God. Amen. All right, here's an assignment with your family. Are you ready? I want you guys to draw a remember wall. Maybe it's just on a piece of paper. Maybe it's a remember piece of paper. I want you to think about all the times that God talked to you, all the times that you saw God working. Maybe it's that your family is safe. Maybe it's that your dog was lost and then he's found. Maybe it's that he answered your prayers in one way or the other. Maybe it's just these stories like Moses that you know. Draw it. Write it. Remember it. Love you.